So now that I have my measurements, what I'm going to do is I'm going to see if this is level. So to see if it's level, I'm just going to turn it on the wheel and run my needle tool gently on the top. And you'll see it's scraping right there. So what that tells me is that this side is higher than this side because the scratches are from here to here. So the middle part of that scratch, which is right here, is the opposite of where I want to raise this. So I'm going to put my finger here so I know that I need to make this a little bit higher. I'm gonna take my clay. And you want the clay to be a little bit on the hard side when you use little wedges. So I'm making a little wedge like this to lift it up just slightly. So now there's about a 16th inch of room under there. I'm gonna see, now it's scraping all the way along, which is exactly what I want. I mean, there's just a little hair where it's not scratching, but it could also be where I cut it off. And when you're cutting these off, make sure you cut all the way through, because if not, then half of it's lower than the other half anyways, which puts you at a disadvantage when you're trimming. I should have trimmed this all the way through and I didn't, so this part's a little higher than that anyways. So I might actually just go down a little more just because of that. I'm just pushing that down a little. So once it's centered, meaning leveled, what I'm gonna do is center it on the side. So I can already tell this is a little bit off. It's kind of wobbling back and forth. So if you put your finger next to it, you can see how it's just kind of like going back and forth on the wheel. Try to center it as much as possible on the bottom here, but the lip is sometimes off from the top, so I just need to make sure that it's on center by putting my needle tool right here. I usually go about an inch from the bottom and that's where I center. This is at a 90 degree angle to the cylinder. I know that it's off. I'm gonna push it that way against the middle of this scratch. So this is the scratch and I'm pushing that way. And this is the middle of the scratch. Then I'm gonna heal up that scratch with my finger. I can even use some water because I don't wanna get confused as to whether I've used that as a measurement before or not. And I'm gonna do that again and see if I got it on center. And once again, I can already tell it's scratching right there. So I'm gonna just go a little bit more, put my thumb in the center and push just a little bit more against that scratch. I'm gonna try it again, clean off my needle tool. So that scratch is now a bit longer, which is good. And it goes from here all the way to here. And so the middle of it is right here, so I'm just gonna push gently that way. The longer this is, the more on center it is. The smaller it is, the more off center it is. I can also feel with my finger, and actually, that's right on center. So once it starts kind of scraping all the way around, you can hear it and you can also see the line going all the way around. You have it on center. And then what you can do is take some clay. You want the clay to be moist and malleable, but you don't want it to be too hard where it starts cracking in your hands. And you don't want it to be so soft that it's like sticky on your fingers. If it's sticky on your fingers, then what happens is this piece will go flying off the wheel because it's drier than these are. And if these are too hard, they won't stick to the wheel head. So you just want the right softness. I just push these balls across from each other. So if I push them on the same side, it'll push it the opposite way. So I just want to counteract that by pushing them on both sides.